Republican Senator Richard Burr is being investigated for possibly engaging in insider trading. Now, the story of Richard Burr is one that we've told quite a few times. And just to refresh everybody's memory, February 2020, before the coronavirus pandemic made its way to American shores, there was that closed-door meeting with a bunch of lawmakers where they talked about what they knew was about to happen. And then, of course, immediately after the meeting, a lot of them got on the phone to their stockbrokers and said, hey, oh my God, this thing's happening. Let's sell this. Let's buy this. Many of them actually got popped for this. Richard Burr was one of them who it is believed, okay, I can't say they definitely did it. He's been accused of doing the same thing. But according to SEC filings that were revealed this week, that's not the only phone call that Richard Burr made after that meeting. He also made a 50-second phone call to his brother-in-law, a man by the name of Gerald Fouth. 50 seconds, that's it. Talked to his brother-in-law. And then records show that immediately after that phone call was made, Mr. Gerald Fouth called his stockbroker too. Yeah, kind of busted there, Burr. Because we already know that you called your broker. We know that you dumped stocks. But then you wanted to, hey, I guess you wanted to be a good brother-in-law, right? Call him up and say, listen, blah, 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 blah. And then the guy immediately calls his broker. You're going to tell us that that's just totally a coincidence, that you didn't let him know the insider information that you had from that meeting? Bullcrap. I think this could be the end of Republican Senator Richard Burr. But more importantly, I hope this is the end of Senator Richard Burr, and I hope that if we can prove he did these things that he is being accused of, again, he has not, you know, been indicted for any of this, there are no charges against him, and of course, he has not been convicted. But if it turns out that he did these things, that it is alleged that he did, that it says he did in these SEC filings, then he should be arrested, he should be tried, and he should go to jail. And the reason this is so important is because nobody ever gets held accountable. How many stories have we had in the last 2 years of Republican lawmakers, Democratic lawmakers, dumping stocks after closed-door meetings? And of course, a lot of that happened after the COVID meetings they had in early 2020. And again, it was both Republicans and Democrats who were doing this. None of them got in trouble. Even an FBI investigation into Kelly Loeffler, they walked away saying like, no, everything's totally cool. Even though she also called her husband, who was what, president of the stock exchange, and he dumped a bunch of stocks and purchased a bunch of different, like, no, there has to be punishment. Somebody has to go to jail. Not just to send a shot across the bow to these other lawmakers about using their insider knowledge to gain financially from it, but also to maybe light a fire under their asses to pass legislation that bars them from owning stocks in the first place. I know a lot of people say they shouldn't be allowed to trade stocks. That's not good enough. They shouldn't be allowed to own stocks. Perhaps in a retirement account that they're not allowed to touch or really even look at except to see the balance every quarter. Beyond that, no. And I know that'll never happen because they would have to impose that rule upon themselves, which they will not do. So the next best thing we could get is having one of their own go to jail for doing the thing that far too many other lawmakers are also doing. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our channel for fresh content 7 days a week.